Welcome back to the video lecture series on embedded systems. This is lecture number 12 and we are into module number 2. So the contents covered in this lecture are instruction description part 1. That is, I have divided these instructions into 4 to 5 video lectures. So in that I am considering the first part. So if you consider the Cortex M3, so the instructions have been divided into 4 types. One is moving the data, then data processing, execution flow control instructions, then special instructions. We will elaborate one by one. Okay. So first, if you consider the moving a data. So in Cortex M3, it is or in any processor, it is the basic fundamental instruction. So a processor or a controller must provide the users to move the data. So how many possibilities will be there? Moving the data between the registers, that is the first thing. Then between memory and registers, then special registers to registers, and moving some immediate value into the register. So one thing here you have to note is exclusively for moving the data between register to memory and memory to register, we need to use load and store instructions. First one, moving data between register and register. So it is a quite common thing we need to understand here is, so the once you choose the movement of data between registers, so the destination and source should not be the same. That is the one thing. Okay, say for a simple example, if you consider here, so it will be that is moving the data from register. So if you want to move the content of R3 to R8, so it looks like this, the instruction move R8 comma R3, where R8 is the destination and R3 is the source. So here you remember that the move instruction is like a copy instruction. It is not like a cut paste instruction, it is like a copy paste. So that means only the content of R8 are updated, R3 value will remain as it is. Okay, another popular instruction in the move is what we have is MVN, that stands for move negative. About all these instructions, I will be uploading one more video, that is demonstration video. So that will be covered in the next lecture. In today's lecture, we shall see only the instruction descriptions. Okay, first one. Next one is moving an immediate value into a register. Previously we have seen moving the data between a register to register. Now we shall see how Cortex M3 allows the users to move the value, immediate value, into the register. So that means immediate value will act like a source here. Destination can be any register. So first option, if you want to move an immediate data, say for example 8 bits or less, so you need to use the instruction move yes. Okay, it is mandatory. So for 8 bit or lesser value data, so for example I can have move R0 comma hash 0x12. So that means R0 will set to hexadecimal value 0x12. Okay, so for a larger value, say more than 8 bits, if you want to use, or maybe thumb 2 instructions if you want to use, so you can use the extension like move w again dot w. okay. So dot w, it is like a word. Word means, so here it allows the users to update data of up to 32 bits. Okay, so this w indicates a 32 bit value. Okay, up to 32 bit value. So you can use anyone. So if you have exactly 32 bit value, so then you can use two instructions to set the upper and lower half. One is move w dot w r naught from, say for example, if I want to store r naught with the value 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8, that is 10 in hexadecimal. So what I can do is, first I can load first lower half, then I can load the upper half. Okay, so this instruction you can use to load the lower half, this one you can use to load the upper half. So after executing these two instructions, what we can see is the R0 value will reflect like this. Okay, alternatively we can also use load instruction LDR, which we shall see in the coming slides, but anyway, it is a simple one. Node is having the same format, that is destination comma source. Here you have to use the source as equal to. Okay, it is not like an immediate value. You are setting the register to the value of the desired thing. Now, so if you want to move the data between memory and register, this is a very special and very important instruction in Cortex-M3. So if you want to move the data between memory to register or register to memory, so you need to use two instructions. One is load, another one is store. Load is used to transfer the data from memory to register, that is the content of memory location can be copied into the register, and store is for storing the content of register to the memory, that is like a write operation. So first one is, it is like a read operation, and this one is like a write operation. And it allows all the sizes here, byte 8 bits, then half word, that is in Cortex M3 word means it is 32 bit, so it will be how much? Byte means it is 8, this is 16, word means this is 32 and this one is 64. Okay, and Cortex M3 has one more speciality, that is it not only allows the single data load and store operation, but also multiple load and store operation can also be performed. So they are actually referred like LDM, load multiple, STM, store multiple, where M stands for multiple. So in few cases we use exclamation mark. So this is a very important concept here. Okay, so here it indicates whether the destination register has to be updated with respect to the source. Okay, so we shall see in detail. Okay, okay. So another important thing is, what you need to remember is about the format of the store and load. So load instruction is same as the other instructions what we use, that is we have destination followed by source, but only in the case of store instruction it will start with the source first, then destination. Okay, so this you have to remember, it is not like destination comma source, it is source comma destination for store. And remembering this is also very easy. Store, it starts with the letter S. So hence the first operand will be source, second operand can be destination for remembering. Okay. So let us now just explore the commonly used memory access instruction. Commonly used memory access instruction. So which are those instructions? As I told, load and store we need to use. So we have LDR B, where B stands for byte. Okay. So what we can do is we can load the contents of, so let me just write here, this is destination and source. Okay, but here onwards it will be source comma destination. So what kind of data we are able to load? A byte from where to where? Source is rn comma offset. So rn can be any register r0 to r12, plus offset means some immediate value. Okay, so those two value will be added and that will be loaded, means that memory location content will be read through the destination register. Okay, so similarly for half word and for a word and for a double word we can use this. So for double word you can notice that there are two destination operands, RD1 and RD2, to hold the lower half word and upper half word respectively. Okay. Similarly, store instruction. STRB stands for byte, H stands for half word, then double word. So RD means, now RD will act like a source and D will act like a destination, means sorry, rn comma offset will act like a destination. So in this case, say for example here, if you have like r2 comma, okay, r3 comma some offset number like 20, if r3 is already having a value like 100, then plus 20 will be added to this memory location 120. What we have is the contents of R2 will be loaded. Okay, that is in the byte form. So as we know, Cortex M3 also supports the multiple memory access. Okay, so if you consider the multiple memory access, so here we have LDM, STM, again LDM, LDM, STM, STM. Already I have told you that M stands for multiple, but only the thing what you should be careful about is, you should be careful about the things like IA, okay, something like DB. IA stands for increment after. And DB stands for decrement. Before. Okay. So we have four formats: IA, DB, then DA, and as well as one more is there, IB, that is decrement after, increment before. Okay, So we shall see these things in detail in the coming slides. But here, as we know already, so load instruction is meant for purpose of read operation. It will perform read operation. Now it will be multiple reads. Okay. And whereas store instruction is used for storing or writing multiple words or multiple data. Okay. So the things will be discussed in detail in the coming slides. So few examples of pre-indexing memory access instructions. Let us see that. So what do you mean by pre-indexing and post-indexing? So if we use the exclamation mark after the brackets, say for example, if you are using the load instruction, destination comma source. So if you mention the source in the square bracket, and if you mention the exclamation mark, that indicates the pre-indexing. So pre-indexing means, already we know what is LDR, what it does. It will load the contents of RN and offset memory location value to the destination RD operand, right? And if we use pre-indexing, so that means the value of the RD will be either incremented with respect to the in offset value. Okay, so this you will understand with respect to the example. So that pre-indexing can be in terms of word, byte, half word, and double word. Okay, similarly for store also we have the similar kind of instructions. Okay, so I request you to wait till for the demonstration, so there the things will be clarified. So as I told, exclamation mark indicates the updation of base register, and it is optional in some cases. So if you don't use that, the instruction would be just a normal memory transfer with offset from a base address. Okay. Next. So post indexing, if you consider post indexing memory access instruction, what they do, they will carry out the memory transfer using the base address specified by the register and then update the address. Okay, so here is an example, LDR.W. It will give R0 comma in the bracket R1 is mentioned, then comma offset. Okay, so what it does, LDR is like a read operation. What it has to read, it has to read the memory content pointed by R1, okay, with R1 will be updated or pointed to R1 plus offset. If R1 is like 100 and offset is like 20, the location 1 to 0 content will be read through R0 register. Okay, so here are the few instructions which supports these conditions. Again, as I told, we shall see these things in detail in the demonstration. Okay. Next, what we have is to move the data between special register to the registers. Okay. So we know already Cortex M3 has several special registers. To access these registers, we need some instructions. Which are those instructions? MRS and MSR. In the first module, we have seen already. So for example, here, you cannot use the move instruction. You must use what now? The instruction MRS only. Okay. So if you use the instruction MRS, so you will be able to understand this in a clear manner. Just a minute. Okay, so similarly for writing introduce MSR. Okay, so if you want to access APSR, okay, you can use MSR or MRS to access other special register other than APSR, okay, only in the which mode? Privileged mode. So this you have to remember, this is very important. Next, so other than these move instruction, Cortex M3 also supports, even every processor will support anyway, it will also support the push and pop instructions. So push instructions are used to move the data from register to the stack, okay, stack memory. And if you want to, if you use the pop instruction, then to read the content of stack into the required registers. So here if you consider example push, you must use the square flower brackets here, okay. That is, here we have used R0 comma R4 hyphen R7 and R9. So that means R0, R4, R5, R6, R7 and R9 contents will be pushed into the stack memory. So if you pop R2 and R3, so what you are doing is you are popping out the contents into the R2 and R3. This is only the simple example. But usually if you consider a push instruction, it must have a corresponding pop instruction with the same register list. But here if you consider the this example over here, so it is not following that rule, okay. So let us see that, but this is not always necessary. What I have used here is R2 comma R3. So we are supposed to use the same register names, okay, same at least register list. So it is not always necessary, okay. So some of the exceptional cases are like, say if you have pushed R0 to R3 and also the link register. So while popping, you must use link register also. That is what is expected, correct? So what is the allowed exception here? That is, you can use R0 to R3. So, but you can pop out the earlier value which was pushed to the stack of the link register into the program counter also. It is your choice. Okay, so that is the meaning here. Okay, so for your better understanding, let us consider few conditions or few examples related to pre-indexing. Okay, so if you consider the pre-index addressing without a write back, okay, one more is like pre-indexing with write back. That means if you use the exclamation mark, okay, one more is the post-indexing, okay. So how it is operated? So if you consider the pre-indexing addressing, so here the instruction LDR R0 comma in the square bracket, what we have, R1 comma hash 4. So what it does? So pre-indexing means the content of destination, okay, it must be updated with the base register value, okay, or the source. So memory location pointed by R1 plus 4. If R1 is again 100, then 104, the memory location content will be read by R0, but R1 will remain unchanged. So R1 is the base register here, it is not updated. So please listen to this carefully and keep this in mind. R1 is not going to change, that is the base register. Base register means the register which is used in the source, okay. What will change in auto indexing and post indexing? Let us see that. So if you consider the previous case, R1 was unchanged, but in auto indexing, what is happening? R0 is updated to memory location 104 as I considered the previous values, but even R1 is also updated here. R1 initially it was having 100, now it will be having 104 value. Yes, so if you use the exclamation mark, auto indexing will take place. Okay, similarly, if you consider post indexing, so in post indexing, what happens? The R0 value will be pointed to memory location of R1. What I considered R1 as what? 100, correct? So here the R0 will read, let me write it. So R0 will be reading the memory location pointed by R1, so which I have assumed is 100. But at the same time, after that, after this read operation, R1 will be R1 plus 4, that will be 100 plus 4. But here what happened? Here R0 was reading the memory content R1 plus 4, that is 100 plus 4, 104th location content, and also R1 was incremented to 104. Okay, so that is the difference. This is one more Viva question, what you can expect. Then if you make a comparison of the pre-indexing, okay, then with the post-indexing, so pre-indexed addressing, one example, if I take LDR R0 comma R1 comma R2, so that means what here? Do we have the exclamation mark here? No. So R0 will read the content of R1 plus R2. If R1 is 10, if R2 is also 10, 10 plus 10 in hexadecimal, what will be the value? So that memory location value will be read by R0. But R1 base register is going to remain unchanged. Okay, if you consider this in auto indexing, if you use the exclamation mark, what will happen? So these two things are going to add up. First thing is it will add up, and also R1 will also add up. Post indexing, if you consider, what will happen? Only the first base register memory location content will be read by R0, and later R1 will be incremented with this, correct? So see, these are the few scenarios here. So you can consider the few values. So how many zeros are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. R0 is having this value, R1 is having this value. Okay, so what are the possibilities? Okay, so if you consider the memory location, like this one is like a memory location. In this memory location, we have this data. This is the data. So what should happen to R0? So if you use the pre-indexing, so then the auto pre-indexing with write back, that means the auto pre-indexing, this one. So what will happen here now? R0 will read the memory content of R1 plus this value. So it will point where now? Here, to this memory location. What we have here? This value. this value will be read by R0, correct? And also R1 will be updated to the, that is base register will be updated to the offset value. What is the offset value? 4. What is the base register value? Means memory location value. It is 9000 plus 4. So that is updated here. Okay. I hope this one is clear. Okay. So as I told, we will be seeing the move and move negative instruction, right? So move instruction, what it does, it will move the content of source to the destination. So source content will be copied into the destination, correct? So if you assume that the source is R4 and destination is R2, and source is having the value 8 and destination as value 2, so what is happening now? R2 is updated as 8, but R4 will remain unchanged. Okay. Similarly, move negative, the content of source value will be negated, that is one's complement will take place, that value will be stored into the destination. So if you assume that R2 is 2, that is R2 is 02, so if R2 is 02 before execution and after execution, so before execution, after execution, so R2 is 02 means 1 2 3 4, 8 4 2 1, correct? And R8 is 08, 1 2 3 4 8. So after execution, what should happen here? The ones complement of this should be loaded, that means 1111 and 0111, that is F7, and this will be unchanged. Okay. Similarly, if you consider load and store instruction formats, okay, so I have just considered a simple example here. Okay, so before execution, okay, and register content, so what I have written here, LDR R0 comma R1, LDR R0 comma R1. Okay, but if you assume that R1 is pointing, where it is pointing, suppose if it is pointing at 15678 to this location, okay, so if you assume that R1 is pointing to 15678, so then after execution, what should happen? The content of R0, okay, so they should be loaded with the value 10, where? In the R0 register, correct? Okay, so R0, if you consider before execution, if it is having 10, okay, after execution, what should happen? Okay, so in that way it is given here. And also, if you consider that the one more condition, see, it is very simple. Location 15678, it is having the value 10, next location 20, next location 30, next location 40. So what we are doing, we are reading the content of R1, memory location pointed by R1 into R0. Okay, so if you assume that it is pointing here, R1 is pointing here, correct? So after execution, read for load instruction, green for store instruction. So after execution, so R0 should be loaded with what? The memory location content pointed by R1. So that is this value. Okay. Similarly, store instruction, if you consider, store is like what now? Source comma destination. So R2 is holding what value? 30. R2 is holding the value 30. Correct. So source to destination, where R3 content is how much? 1567B. So 1567B, initially before execution it was having 40. Now it will be loaded with what? 30. Okay. Next, load and store instruction, some other variants if you consider, LDR, STR, okay. So with pre-indexing, auto-indexing and all, like we discussed earlier, same thing here also. Then another few set of load and store instructions. B stands for byte, then H stands for, already we have seen, half word, correct? So these are the few more variants here. Next very important instruction is about loading and storing multiple values. Okay, so multiple register load and store, right? So what I told actually earlier, LDM, M stands for multiple. Then I stands for what? Increment. Then A stands for after. Okay. So how it will perform? Load is having destination comma source. Okay. First thing is, it will execute in this way. Content of R3. Okay. The memory content of memory content pointed by R3 will be loaded to R1. Okay, then it will be incremented by 4 bytes. So then it will point to R5, then R6. Okay, similarly, if you consider LDMIB, it will be increment before. Okay, so all these things we shall see in the execution, no need to worry here. Okay. One of the popular example is about multiple store instruction I have considered. Similarly, you can consider it for the load also. So what is that? First one, if you consider this one, store, STMIA, store multiple, increment after, store multiple, first store operation will happen, then increment operation takes place. So it is like store comma increment. So what will happen here now? So we know this is the source register R9. Exclamation mark means it, the value of the R9 will increment. Okay. And these are the destination contents. How the flow will be? R0 to R5. So initially, if I assume that R9 is pointing to this memory location 100C. Okay. So what should happen? First, it should store, then it will increment. Correct. So what it will store? The content of R9 will be stored in R0. First store will happen, then increment. Increment by 4 bytes. So 100C, if you consider, okay. So if you add a 4, So that will be C means after C what you will be having D E F, and after F it will be 10. So it will increment the memory location to 1010. Then after incrementing, what it will do, it will perform the store operation. Then again it will increment. What will be the incremented value? 1014, 4 bytes. So same thing, next value is incremented. So first what happens, it will store, then it will increment, then store, then increment, then store, then increment. So after execution, the R9 will be pointing to this location. Okay. So if you similarly, if you consider store multiple increment before, so first increment will happen, then storing will happen. R9 is pointing where now? 1006. First it will increment, then what will be the value? 1010. Increment by 4 bytes. Okay. Why 4 bytes? 4 into 8, 32. 4 bytes, not bits. Okay. So after incrementing, it will store here. Then again, second time increment will happen. What will be the value? 1014. Then second store will happen. Then again, third increment will happen. Third store will happen. Okay. So like that, the copy will be taking place. Similarly, STMDA means store multiple decrement after. Okay. First it will store, then it will decrement the value. Okay. So, but here the process is reverse. In these two cases, it will be from left to right. But in these cases, what I am about to tell, that will be from right to left. It is like a store operation, source comma destination. The content of R5. So first base value is what now? This one. Presently R9 is pointing here, source. Destination R5. Okay. So R5 will be first stored. Okay. So first it will be stored, then the address will be decremented. So address will be decremented by 4 means C means, then minus 4 means B, A, correct, 9 and 8. So this will be 1008. Okay. First step is to store. Second step is to decrement. Third step is to store again. Fourth step is to decrement. Then fifth step is to store again. Then sixth step is to decrement. So it will be pointing at this location. Similarly, if you consider decrement before, first it will decrement. First it will decrement. What it will decrement? Source register R9 pointing value. Decrement will happen first, so it will be 1008. That is first step. Second step is to store. Third step is to again decrement. Then it will perform the storage. Then again decrement. Then again store. Okay. This is how the multiple store is executed. So here I have given the program, the same program will be executed with change in values if required. Okay. Similarly, we can also execute LDMIA. It can be load, increment after, before. Everything is same what we discussed for the store instruction also. Okay. Then this is the scenario for load and store multiple. So irrespective of you are using store or load, the thing will happen like this. Increment after, it will be upscaling. Increment before, again upward increment. Decrement after, downward. Decrement before, downward. Okay, so increment after and increment before will be left to right, and these things will be from right to left. So this you have to remember. So then coming up to the stack, so we shall see that after performing after push or pop operation, whether the addresses are going to increase or decrease. Okay, so we shall discuss, we have already discussed that it is a descending stack. For every push instruction, the address is going to decrease. For every pop instruction, address is going to increase. Correct? So this program is also related to this lecture only. This will also be executed. Okay. So we shall stop here. We'll continue with the next lecture. Thank you.